Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Let's Play 999. In the last episode, we are here in through the door 6 puzzle. We're here with Ace and Santa, I think? I think we're here with Ace and Santa, and then June, of course, who's down there all fainted and stuff. Sorry if I'm sounding a little confused. I haven't recorded this for like 3 days, and I'm like, where the hell did I leave off again? Anyway, we're in the middle of this big-ass room puzzle. I remember that. And we just came through door A here. We came from the other side. So we gotta look around up here. We haven't finished looking around. There's a B door and a C door. I think I wanna go with the C door first. What do you think? Let's do it. Alright, C door. I'm assuming we are now on the other side again, because there's the A door. But I don't think I can go that way. I think we're kinda stuck on this side. So let's see what's over here. There's a wooden box hanging beneath the catwalk. There's a wooden box on the end of a rope hanging on the winch. It looks like there's something in the box. Well, let's go winch that shit, huh? Winch it! It looks like a hand-operated winch, but it doesn't look like there's any way to, operate it. That means the wheel isn't attached. Okay, so we need a wheel. Got it. This damn pile of boxes is blocking the way. God damn it. Alright, back to the other side. Let's see what's on the other side of door number B. Actually, can we go over there? Catwalk. Well, any way you look, that looks like that's pipe. Looks like the bottom connects to the conveyor belt housing. Then coal must come out of this pipe onto the conveyor belt. In other words, there must be a great deal of coal in that pipe. Okay. And a whole bunch of boxes. Alright, let's go through B and see what's over here. We gotta find some stuff, man. We're, like, lacking things in this room.
You have an excellent memory. Use that to draw a map inside your head. That way you won't get lost.
I know, man. I know where I am. Don't fucking talk to me that way. It's another winch. Ooh, but we have a way to operate this winch. Oh, let's give this wheel a spin. What? That's weird. I don't feel any resistance. Gah! Ah, shit! Oh, that's because the wheel's not really attached. Nailed it. Some pegs on the back that look like they go in the holes on a winch. Guess what? Gotta use it on the other winch, probably, because this one doesn't matter as much. Good job, genius. You broke it. I didn't break it. It broke all by itself. Meh! Hand-operated winch. The wheel it once had is now in my hand. Let's see if I can get it back on. There's a couple of posts on the back of it that look like they fit into the holes on the winch. Damn, no good. These little shafts are too small for this big hole. It's like throwing a hot dog down a hallway, to be honest. Oh, God. I made that joke already.
If that's the case, then, that wheel wasn't originally part of this winch.
Then that means there's another winch! Oh, my God. Winches everywhere, dude. Winches. Talk about winches and throwing hot dogs down hallways. I don't know. I don't know, man. You made the joke. Seriously, though. I made that joke about Lotus, and they just made it for me. Anyway, we got the wheel. There's no way to make this wheel turn in. Oh, yeah. I've got the wheel I pulled off the other winch, don't I? Let's see if it fits.
Indeed. Sweet, it's a perfect fit. Look like they were made for each other. Not shaky at all? Good, I should be able to turn this now. Good work, Junpei. We should be able to haul up the wooden box now. You see, the wooden box? It's under the catwalk. Can you see it? It's hanging from the rope on the winch, isn't it? It looks like there's some sort of device in the box. I'm not sure what it is. At any rate, you might as well turn that wheel now. I'm counting on you.
Ace is such a fucking shit, but I don't even know what to call him. He's such a fucking weirdo. Anyway. Huh? What's this?
What happened?
This wheel only turns to the left.
It only turns to the left.
That means we can't reel up that rope. Yeah, we can only let the rope down.
Interesting. I don't think that will be a problem. We will simply need to go downstairs after letting the wooden box down. I will be counting on you, Junpei.
Sure thing, no sweat. Stop counting on me, Ace. I don't count on you. Stop counting on me, man.
I believe the box has reached the floor.
Oh, yeah? Do you think so?
Yeah.
He stuck his head out over the side of the catwalk and looked down. The box that had only recently hung just below the catwalk now sat on the floor. It had come to rest near the end of the tunnel that covered the conveyor
June's
belt.
June's down over by there.
Junpei could see her, still leaning against the wall as if she barely had the strength to sit up. Even from so far away, it was not difficult to see that she had not improved. He almost thought he could see heat rising from her body.
She doesn't seem to be improving.
Ace's expression was inscrutable, but he'd said what they had all been
thinking. Well, of course not. She's not going to just get better right away, you know? It'll take time.
Adur. He tried desperately to convince himself that what he'd said was
what
true.
What could be causing this, I wonder? Illness, perhaps?
Nah.
She's in heat, dude. Didn't we already fucking establish this in, like, the first episode or the second episode? Anyway, she's got to be exhausted. Santa's response was confident and certain.
She gets dropped into some weird-ass ship, forced to play some messed-up game. If you think about it, it's a lot weirder that we aren't freaking out just like her, you know?
So you're saying we're abnormal?
Yeah. We're just running around this room, solving all these puzzles like it's just business as usual. How the hell could you call that normal? We're just guinea pigs.
Santa snorted in disgust.
Guinea pig? You mean like a lab rat? You mean we're being used for some sort of experiment? Is that what you're saying?
Dunno. But it does seem like a possibility, you know?
They stood there for a few more minutes, no one speaking, until Santa turned and walked away from the winch. Junpei and Ace followed him. And away we go. Alright. So, if anything, that experiment thing feeds into the whole story we learned from Seven on the other path, right? About experiment on the ship and blah, 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 like all that stuff. That is all in tune with that story, 100%. So the details are only becoming more and more obvious. There's a pair of boxes here. Is this not the box that we winched down? No? Where's the box that I winched down? Winched down. I'm lost. Where's my box winch? Where's my winchy? Where is it? Oh, there it is. Wooden box. Let's see what's inside. I'm trying. Control panel for something. Some kind of machine. Maybe a control panel? Looks like some kind of control panel. It's got three terminals on the back. Ah, there it is. That's what I like to see. It goes right up in here. Nice. Maybe this hole is where the control panel goes. Well, there's only one way to find out. In you go, bitch. All right. Dude, you did it. Everything looks all right. Okay, but what do we do now? Why don't you press the button next to it? The orange one? Yes. All right, I'll do that. Pushing. Sweet, all sorts of lights are lighting up on this thing. And, oh, yes, I think I just heard something turn on. Oh, what's that? What happened? Junpei, look, the conveyor belt's moving. Conveyor belt? Yeah, there's the conveyor belt, you know? Well, I guess it's done moving now. There's still a bunch of coal on the belt, though. Looks like a bunch of it got dumped off on the end of the belt into that wooden box where we found the control panel. Coal, huh? It's like, I don't know, maybe I need that shit. It all dropped off left and end of the belt right into the wooden box. Well then, we'll just take a box filled with coal, small wooden box full of coal. Guess there's really only one thing we can do with this stuff. Burn that bitch! Is this the holes we need to put it in? This is where the coal goes, or would it if all three of these hadn't rusted shut? Which one had the holes that we can, it's the other side, right? Or, I thought it was this side that has all the... Hold up, wait a minute. How do I get back to the other side? Wait, didn't I like... I went around the room, right? This... Was these holes? Wait a second. Go that way. And then go... No. I thought there was holes here that we could actually, like, interact with. There is, but where the hell are they? Is it these ones? It's these ones. Ah, here we go. Put that coal in there. There's a hole that'll let us put coal into the furnace. Maybe if we can get some coal in there and set it on fire. Okay, let's do it. Booyah. Alright, that's the last of it. No coal left in the wooden box, and nothing. Great. Well, I guess I should have expected that. Why would just throwing coal in the old cold furnace do anything? Ah, well, a man can dream. Junpei, explain it to me again. You're planning to stoke the furnace with coal, which will heat the water stored up there and make steam, which will then drive something else. Am I correct? In other words, you want to generate enough pressure with the steam to power the turbine and drive the steam engine, right? Yeah, I guess that's the gist of it. Well, in that case, this isn't enough coal. This furnace is enormous, so So we're gonna need a whole hell of a lot more coal than this. Very well then, if the three of us work together, then we should manage to fill it much faster.
I want to help too.
Man, I totally didn't even see her walk up. Are you feeling up to that?
Yes.
Yeah, right. You look like you're one stiff breeze away from falling over, June.
I think you'd better get better rest tomorrow, alright?
But, no arguing. You need your rest, so just stay there. We'll handle this.
Okay, I understand.
Alright, time for some manly work. Let's get this coal into those furnaces, bitches. Three holes, three men, let's do it. And away we shovel. And we shovel. Any more? Are we good? Man, this is a lot of work. Alright, I think this should be sufficient. Alright, now we just gotta light it. Junpei, hand me your matches.
What makes you think I have matches?
I see. Then how are we gonna light it? Perhaps there's a device nearby that will allow us to remotely ignite the coal. Let's take a look, shall we?
Some sort of ignition device, huh?
Well, I have an idea of what device that might be, but I don't know if I'm able to activate it quite yet. I think I'm missing what I need to activate it, assuming that the thing to activate it is the thing that I think it is. Which, unless it's up here. Wait, hold up. Wait, whoa. I already looked at the, there's nothing there. No, I want to go up these stairs. Did we check this? Let's check this. Is this? I think it might be. It probably is. I think this might be where we ignite the furnace. That means if we move that thing down... Alright, let's do it! Here we go! Hey, Junpei. Ace, look at this! There's big gears turning under the boiler here. Sick. Okay, I forgot about that one. Ooh, there's... Now there's... Oh, I already see what the clues are, too. The gears... They're spinning. What the hell are you guys waiting for? Let's start looking! Yeah, I know, dude. There's gears. We get it. There's things on the gears. Take them. Give me. Now we got puzzles. The gold disc. It has a number of lines engraved on it. I can make out three colors here. Red, blue, and black. I wonder what they mean. I already have an idea, dude. There's a puzzle that has these three exact circle thingies. And we are going to have to put them in the right order to make a shape, which... just straight up looks like a fucking Jewish star. Whatever, the Star of David, whatever it's called. I think that's right. Anyway, I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. It has a bunch of lines on it, but the red ones really stand out. The red ones, huh? Alright, yup. It actually is not the Star of David at all. It's got a lot more points than that. But let's go ahead and do the puzzle. It looks like this thing unlocks the door. There's a depression here that looks like it has the outline of three circles laid on top of each other in a triangle. Maybe if we put those three discs we found into this thing. Well, there's only one way to find out. Let's stick them in. Huh? That's odd. Nothing's happening. Maybe you're, I don't know, putting them in the wrong places? Perhaps you have them facing the wrong directions. Perhaps you should rotate the discs to make some of the lines connect to one another? Well, no harm in trying. Yeah, no shit. Alright, here we go. When the disc is touched, it will rotate a certain amount. When the white arrow is touched, the discs are switched. Please note, when the discs are switched, the angles for the disc are reset. Okay, got it. Okay, so I'm assuming the red is what we need to line up. Okay, interesting. Maybe red isn't what we need to line up, but I assume it is. Let's see. Oh, we might need to switch them, right? Okay, I wasn't even thinking about switching them. Okay, I'm thinking this one probably needs to go up here. Maybe. Let me flip this around and see. Does that line up at all? Not really. No. Let's put this one up top. So, if that's up top, and then this one spins this way. Oh, this is like the big one. Okay. So the one with the least amount of stuff has to go up top, I think. This one has the most. Okay, what makes it most centered? We have to center it. That's the main thing. Okay, so does this center it at all? I think that pretty well centers it. Actually, this might be... Let's swap these two real quick. There we go. I think we got it. I think we have solved it. Yeah! The red lines on these discs. I think maybe I can make a star polygon with these. Sick! Love them star polygons. Also, door open! Sick! That means I solved it, right? That's it? We're done? Hell yeah!
Damn, that was fast. I didn't expect to figure that one out so quickly, since the room was so huge. I thought there was gonna be like a bunch of puzzles.
Yes! The door's open!
Sick!
Given the circumstances, Junpei's happiness was certainly understandable. Ace seemed to share his excitement.
Alright, Junpei. Why don't you go get June now? Santa and I will keep an eye on this door.
Santa snorted.
Why do we need to do that? Even if it shuts, we know how to solve the puzzle now. We could just open it again.
Well, I suppose that's true. Shall all three of us go and collect June, then?
Nah, I'm cool. I'll let Junpei handle it.
He still seemed irritated by something, however, and sat down on the stairs petulantly. I can read that
word. So are you only interested in being contrary?
Ace sighed, with an air of a long-suffering parent.
All right. I'll go get June. I'll be right back.
He gave a quick nod to Ace and Santa and dashed off down the stairs. Okay, June, where you at? Before long, he was back on the first floor next to the conveyor belt, and June.
Oh, Jumpy!
I'm here. As he drew closer, she stood up slowly.
Are you okay?
He did his best to sound calm and nonchalant, but there was no hiding the genuine concern in his voice.
Yes, I'm fine now. I'm sorry I made you worry.
June blushed. He wasn't sure if she was embarrassed or still feverish.
Let me check.
Just to make sure, he reached out and put his hand against her forehead.
Good. You're feeling a lot better.
Something about them Asian girls and getting their head touched by, like, patted on the head. It's some kind of weird thing that they like. I don't know. I don't know this for a fact, but I've heard about this, that it's a weird thing that with especially in an Asian country. Anyway, enough about the stereotypicalness. She was feeling far less warm than she had earlier, but still wasn't down to what seemed normal to him.
Are you sure you're all right?
He had to be sure. June gave him a look.
Oh, you're such a warrior, Jumpy. Oops, I mean, warrior.
I didn't mean to call you so manly and awesome. I thought, you know, you're just normal. You're just normal awesome, you know. He wasn't sure if she just made a joke or not, but seeing her smile again made Junpei feel at ease. If she was well enough to smile and laugh, then she really was feeling much better. He gave her a friendly poke on the forehead.
All right, let's go.
Go where?
Oh, right, I didn't tell you. We got the exit open, so...
Great! Let's go!
Let's go! June clasped her hands and nodded urgently. Here we go. And we're gonna get there, and they're both gonna be dead! No, I don't know. Headed back to the exit, but on their way they found...
it's...
Santa?
Santa was sitting on the stairs. He was, however, holding something in his right hand and staring at it with a strange expression. Junpei and June slowed down and finally stopped in front of him.
What are you looking at?
You don't want to know. Santa answered without looking up, his voice
it's
quiet.
It's a photo. It's my sister.
Sister?
Oh, we're going to get real right now, guys. We're going to get real. Santa simply nodded.
Yeah. Kid was cute as a button.
June cocked her head, confused.
She was only about an inch tall then?
Oh. Funny joke, June. Santa glared at her.
Oh, sorry. I guess an inch is a little large for a button. Probably more like a half inch.
Santa didn't smile or laugh.
Sorry.
Why are you looking at it?
He simply turned back to this picture and spoke.
It was her Santa Claus. Wait, what?
This sudden revelation took Junpei by surprise. He had no idea what Santa meant. He glanced at June, who shook her head. She didn't know either.
Have you ever heard the story of the two Santa Clauses? It goes that a long time ago, there were two Santas. One of them wore white, and the other one wore black. The white Santa gave presents to good kids, and the black Santa played tricks on bad kids. They went on like that for a while, but eventually the black Santa's tricks started to get worse and worse. Pretty soon, the white Santa couldn't stand it anymore, and he stabbed the black Santa.
Jesus. Racist.
When he stabbed the other Santa, the white Santa got blood all over his clothes, and that's why, these days, his clothes are red.
Wow, I don't think I've ever actually heard that story.
You could
that's
say
funny.
That red is all that's left of the black Santa.
Wow. Junpei was silent. He could think of nothing to say. June was staring at Santa, sadness plain on her face. He continued.
I wonder which Santa I am. The white Santa or the black Santa?
Huh.
Aw.
All right. Let's go.
Santa stood up suddenly, his downcast demeanor gone. He shoved the picture back in his pocket and headed back up the stairs, taking them two at a time. Oh, hello.
Huh?
Junpei and June looked at one another.
There was nothing they could think of to say.
Hey, what are you two doing? Let's get moving, come on!
Don't rush me, bitch! Santa's voice echoed across the room from above them.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Alright, they nodded and followed him quickly up the stairs. Ace was waiting for them at the top. He was leaning against the handrail. He looked very tired.
Oh, you're finally back.
God, take forever, shit.
Door had shut, but it wasn't cause for concern.
Sorry we took so long.
Junpei quickly solved the disc puzzle a second time, and the door opened once again.
Alright, let's go then. Let's go!
Oh, let's go. In single file, they walked through. After walking for nearly 15 feet, they found themselves in front of a metal door. It opened easily enough, and they passed through it as well. A new room stretched out before them. Hey, hey, hey. A new room, which means another puzzle.
Is this a warehouse?
No, I believe this is the cargo room. This must be where they store all of this vessel's freight.
Okay.
There are wooden crates everywhere. I wonder how old they are.
Junpei, Ace, and June had stopped unconsciously, pausing to take in their new surroundings. Santa's voice broke through their momentary trance.
Well, we probably ought to start with finding the exit, right? Let's get going.
And puzzle number two for behind door number six is underway. Here we go. Let's seek that shit, homie.
Seek a way out.
I'm fully expecting a big, long, like, monologue-y fucking story in this area. I mean, we didn't really get one in the last room. I mean, Santa gave us a little bit about the bad Santas. The black Santa, whatever, but I expect maybe Ace will give us a heart-to-heart just to see if he gives us some details that give us anything useful. Anyway, I don't know what's in these barrels. Judging by their weight, perhaps a liquid of some sort. Okay. There are a bunch of bags here. I wonder what's in them. Card with a headshot? What? What? Card with Snake's face printed on it? What? What's that? It's a card. It has a headshot on it. A headshot? Yeah. I'm not really sure what purpose this could possibly serve. What the fuck? What the actual fuck? There's nothing in these crates. What about this bag? What the fahabahawa? Now I'm just confused. Or excited, because this could mean we're finally gonna learn stuff about everybody. Oh, we're about to learn stuff about everybody. All the excitement cannot be contained. All the excitement. I am so excited right now. This just made me all sorts of giddy. These stairs, they go up three stories. What are you waiting for, Junpei? Whatever, I'm going. Okay. This is the only door here, except for the one we just came in through. Then this is the exit. No shit, Sherlock. Of course it's locked. Is it an electronic lock? No, just a keyhole right under the doorknob. So to open this door, we gotta find the key that fits that keyhole. Yep. Alright. Nailed it. Alright, let's see what's up here. Buttons, buttons. Who's got the buttons? Oh, this is probably the card reader. You know what? Before we even do this? Okay. We need to... I don't want to do this yet. I want to finish finding all these cards, because I'm assuming we're going to find all seven of them. We've searched all the boxes. There's nothing in them. Bet you there's one in this bag, though. Hell yeah, dude. There's seven. It's a sevens card. This is supposed to be a trading card. It's not a very good one. Look at that face, though. Whoa, this one's going to be a little more... Oh, maybe... Oh, we're going to do a puzzle with it. Never mind on the card reader up there. This is a puzzle for the cards. Okay, nailed that. I'll look at that again later. Ooh, two more cards. There's me. Not cool, man. You took this picture without my permission. Looks pretty cool, though. You look really handsome in the picture. Hey, knock it off, lovebirds. What? We're not a couple. Not at all. Not in any way. Not yet, anyway. And this one's probably of her. Yup. This must be. Oh no. Don't look at it. I'm not cute at all, and I'm not photogenic. I don't look sexy either. Next to Clover, my skin looks gross. And I'm not sexy like Lotus. I know guys go for women who look like Lotus. But. I'm trying to. I'm doing the best I can. So please don't call me a board or a trash can or a cutting board or... Wait a minute. I haven't said anything like that, have I? Some girls, man, their self-image is all fucked up. There is some sort of liquid in these barrels. I'm not sure what it is, however. I don't care about liquid, dude. There's bags everywhere, dude. Bags everywhere. Alright, there's the Santa card, and the only one left would be man number 9. Wait, no, we only have 7, so we're missing 2 of them. Man, the guy on this card is a good one looking son of a bitch. Way more class than that other chump. Hey, what's that supposed to mean? Huh? What's your problem? Didn't say I meant you, did I? Shit. That's funny. A box. There's nothing inside. Okay. These crates are quite large. They seem to be tied to one another with sturdy straps. Okay, that's the box I think we already got shit out of. Let's check this bag. This bag is going to have... Well, it's either going to have the 9th guy or it's going to have the other one. It has the 9th guy. So that's 8. Who are we missing? We're missing Lotus, of course, duh. This guy. This card has the 9th man on it. He is the first victim of the no-nary game. Actually, come to think of it, he was acting pretty weird. Wonder what his deal was. I don't know, dude. I don't know. Anyway, we got one more card to find. Bet you it's in this box. This is the only area with a fence around it. Junpei. Think you could go take a look at that? Sorry, but no thanks. Why? I got a bad feeling about it. Pussy. Okay, fine. I'll go. Please be careful, Santa. Yeah. But just in case. Wait, what's he gonna do with that screw? I don't see what throwing a screw at a fence is. Holy shit! Oh man. There's electricity running through that fence. Looks like it. Then we can't get to the other side. Well, we could jump off those crates, but we wouldn't be able to get back. Yeah, we're definitely not going to do that right now. No, I want to check this box, dude. Think we can get over the fence by jumping on those crates? What are you saying, Jumpy? There's a huge electrical current flowing through that fence. If you do that, you won't be able to get back. Well, if I can move some of the crates over there... Are you even sure you can move them? Or if they weigh too much, then what are you going to do? Oh, yeah. I hadn't thought of that. I'm trying to check this box on the ground. What the fuck? What the... Okay, hold on. This box on the ground, yo... Is it not pressable? Does this box on the ground mean nothing to you? Alright, apparently means nothing. Alright, well then apparently we're missing... The last card must be on the other side, which means we gotta go up to that terminal. I bet you that terminal is like a fucking crane or some shit. Let's see. Let's fucking check. Let's go up the fucking crane. Yeah, go up. Up. Let's see. What does this do? Some sort of boxy device. Alright. Monitor's off. I got a green switch here and a red one. Some kind of lever. None of them seem to do anything, though. Maybe the power's off. Yeah, maybe. There's a single green light on the bottom, though. That means... Wait a second. Can this do something down here? Hold up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 is already lit up. Several lights from numbers 1 through 9. Only the light with number 9 is lit. Well, there's 6 holes here. They look like jacks for a headphone cable. Jacks, huh? Maybe if we put something in them. Yeah, something might happen. Looks like it's covering something. Kind of shutter. Maybe it'll open if we do something. What's going to come out of it if it pops open? Yeah, I'd like to know that. Okay, maybe we got to do this shit with the cards now, then. Let's just go do it. We're missing a card, though. I feel like we should have all 9 of them. Maybe... Wait, this is the door we came in, right? Yeah. That bag's already empty. Is this bag over here? Is this bag over here? I think it's the bags we already did. And I looked in both these bags already, right? Like, opened. Huh. I'm confused by this box on the ground. I still think... I feel like it's there for a reason, but apparently it's not, because otherwise it would let me interact with it, I'm sure. And there's crates there, and I already checked this bag for stuff. So we're just missing a bag. Maybe one of these has? I don't know. Let's just try it. It's locked. No shit. We need the key. All the boxes have numbers on them. Do they? Oh. Ace bent down and picked up something that had been sitting next to the box. Junpei, take a look at this. Cards. Oh, well, there's the fucking 9th one. Never mind, I'm looking for the 9th one. There's a picture of Lotus on this card. Man, her hair is ridiculous. It's like clay or something. Says the pot to the kettle. Ooh, he went there. All right. So what are we doing here? All right. So
now
we got all nine of them.
All nine picture cards. All
right.
We just need to insert these cards into the slots at the front of each box.
Uh-huh. Junpei stared at the cards in his hands. Ace peered over his shoulder at them.
You know which card goes in which box, yes?
Hell yeah, I do. Junpei gave him a look.
Yeah, of course I do. It's really obvious. You just match our numbers to the numbers. Then
oh,
you
shit.
Pop the corresponding card in the right box. So for instance, the card with the picture of Ace on it goes into box one.
Damn right.
The card with the picture of Snake on it goes into box two. And
got
so
it, got it, got
oh,
it.
Oh, I see.
Genius,
huh?
I know.
What is it?
Junpei thought he might have imagined it, but he could have sworn Ace stiffened.
I'll leave the rest to you.
Hey, wait!
He quickly turned and walked away.
Oh well, whatever.
Is he afraid that if we put the wrong one in the wrong hole, we... I don't know, man. Anyway, doing his best to clear his mind for the task at hand, he turned back toward the boxes.
Time to solve the nine boxes puzzle.
Alright, here we go then. Nine cards with nine pictures. Or nine cards with pictures and nine boxes. Junpei stared at them for a moment and then began.
Ace's card is in box one, Snake's is in number two. I just need to do the same for the rest.
Are they gonna make me remember
finally,
it myself?
The ninth
no.
man's card into box nine.
Okay. All the box lids opened at once.
Yeah. Oh, they opened.
He peered inside. In each box was a single pin.
Nine.
Aha!
Pins?
They looked a little like sewing pins, but much thicker.
I guess I'll take them with me.
Junpei collected them all quickly and shoved them into his pocket. Okay. Well, I know what we're going to do with these. These look like the kind of pins you use for sewing. There are nine of them in total, and they have numbers 1 through 9 on them. I already know what to do with them, I think. Well, the only thing I can think of like for this puzzle up here is if we have to use the root, but we have to use six. Maybe we have to use six numbers to make the root of 9. That's why there's a 9 number lit up here. Let's try it. Six holes, and it looks like the pins I just found would be perfect to fit for them. The ones you found in the nine boxes, right? Well, why don't you try on? Or why don't you try it? Whatever. Alright, let's see what happens. I think 2, 4, 6 should go here on the top part and 3, 5, 7 on the bottom part. Well, some of them lit up. Yeah, 3 and 6. I wonder if there's some kind of rule that determines which lights go on. Well, I put the 2, 4, 6 on the top and the 3, 5, 7 on the bottom. Huh. You think? I think maybe it's the digital root? The digital root. 2, 4, 6. Yep, it's 12. The digital root is 3. Therefore, light 3 turns on. 3, 5, 7, 15. Digital root of 15 is 6. Therefore, light 3, 6 turns on. Makes sense, right? I see. The lights that match the digital root of the pins inserted on the top and lower parts will light up. So that's how it works. Well, there's one other thing I'd like to check. Well, if he wants to try, he's certainly welcome to. So, he put the 1, 2, 3 on the top and the 6, 7, 8 on the bottom. Oh? It turned off. 6, 7, 8 is 21. The digital root of 21 is 3. Therefore, light 3 turns off. 1, 2, 3 is 6. The digital root of 6 is 6. Therefore, light turns off. Oh, I get it now. If the digital root for the pins you insert is the same as the number on the lights that are in lit, those lights turn off. Yep, looks like that's the trick. Alright, now we know how it works. You want to give it a try? Wait, you mean you know what we're supposed to do with these lights? Well, no, but I kind of figured we could try and see if we turn them all on, you know? I figure something's got to happen if we can manage that. Turn on all the lights, huh? Yep, let's do it. Okay, let's make sure you know this works alright. Pick one of the six holes, then pick one of the pins in your hand and insert it into the hole. Keep it until all six of the holes are filled. Once all the holes are filled, the lights... Okay, so basically how this works, I can already see. Yeah. I don't think I really need to go over this. All right, let's do it. So I think what we need to do here is we need to do this in pairs. So we can't forget one of them. Basically, we have to make sure that every time we do one of these, we have to do two numbers we haven't already lit up. Because there's eight numbers here, and we don't want to unlight 9 unless we absolutely have to. So I'm going to start with the one... Do I have to pick holes first? I guess I do. It's kind of lame. I wish if you just clicked it, it would go on the first one. So let's do 1, 2, 3. And then we'll do... What did he do? He did 7, 8, 9 or 6, 7, 8? Is it 13 plus 8 is 21? And that's 3? Yeah, 6, 7, 8 it was. Yeah. All right, so we're back to where we were a second ago. All right, so now if we want to do a 1, we need 10. So that would be 2, 4, 6 is 12. No, we want 1, 3, 6. That's 10. And we should be able to knock out another one pretty easily. So let's do 1 first. Oops, well, whatever. It's 1, 3, and 6. And then the other one let's do a high number maybe. Let's do 8. 1 and 8 should be doable. So to get 8, we need a 17. So 9 plus 5 plus 4, that's 18. 9 plus 8 plus 5 plus 4, that's 17. Let's do that. And that'll be 8. Yep. I don't really like this clunky-ass interface. It'd be much faster on a touchpad or a mouse. All right, so that's 1 and 8. Now let's do 2 and... 4 and 5 is going to be tough, I think. Let's do 2 and 5. Keep it spread out a little bit. So for 2, we need 11. And then for 5, we need 14. So 14 could be 9, 3, and 2. Right? That's 12, 13, 14. Yeah, that's 5. Could be 9, 3, and 2, or 9, 4, and 1 to get, what did I just say? To get 14. But we need to get 12 also. We could do 6, 3, and 2. So yeah, 1. What did I just say? Shit. It was 1, 4, and 9. That's 14. And then 2. Hold on. Let me just get these out of the way so I have the numbers out of the way so I'm not confusing myself. So that's 14. That'll get rid of the 5. Now we want to get the 2. The 2 would mean we need 11. So to get 11, we need the 6 and the 5. So by 6 and a 5, I mean a 6 and a 2 and a 3. Alright, so now our last combination is going to be a 4 and a 7. Let's see if we can pull that off. We need 13 and we need 16. 13 and 16. Okay, let's see how we can do that. So if I have 9 with 1 and 6, that's 16. And then to get 13, we can do 8, 2, and 3. We need 13, right? Yep, okay. I think we're good. I think we got this. So 6... 9, 1, that is 16, which equals 7. And then on the bottom, we want, what'd I say? I said we want 13, so 7, no, what'd I say? Shit. Well, we want 13, so 2, 3, and 8 work. I don't know if that's what I said before, but that works too. We did it! Yay! Easy peasy. Shit, we got an F! All the lights are on and the shutter's open. Hey, does that mean... Yeah, we gotta do it again. Man, I thought I was doing so well. Shit, what is this one? Okay, so now we got 9 holes, and there's an F above them. I don't know what the F means, but I do know one thing. What's that? This time there's 9 holes, so we need to insert 9 pins. Man, that's boring. Well, why don't you just try it, alright? Okay. So, we need to get an F. What does that mean? Is this like a Sudoku puzzle where all directions have to add up to the same thing? Actually, that might not be it. That might not be too far from the truth, honestly. But that would mean... What would that mean? That would mean that we need to... Hold on. Usually with Sudoku, it's easier to start throwing some numbers out there. So what I'm going to do is this... I'm probably gonna swap. No, that should be fine. No, I'm gonna move this here. Swap those. So now we got 15, 14, 15, 16. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so I think we want the 1 here, maybe. 1 can maybe go here. 2 can go... Let's see, we got 15 twice. So we have 15 twice, 14 once. Let's go with the 2 here, and the 3 here. We'll put the 4 here. And I don't think this is right. Nope, this is already incorrect. Already incorrect. Because now I'm equaling... I don't know what I'm trying to equal is the problem. F is how much? 15? 15 in hex? F is 15, right? Yeah, okay. So, if F is 15, then we're adding up to too high of a number here. Alright, so we need to move this and this. Let's make the 9 go here, and the 2 here. 9... 9, 2, and this would have to be a 4 here. This is gonna be a minute. I can do math. I got math. Math for the win. Yo. Alright. So that's 15 there on top, right? 11, yeah, 15. So if I need 9 this way to go be 15, I would need the 1 and the 5, maybe? Maybe put the 1 here. And then put the 3 here. I'm just gonna keep replacing it, and then maybe it'll accidentally solve it while I'm moving shit around. So that's 15 this way, 15 this way. Let's do 15 across the top. If I leave the 4 here, what do I put up here to make it 15? 15, 4, so it has to be an 11, right? So, what can I move to get 11 up there? 8 and a 3. Let's move the 3 up there. 3, you can sit here. Alright, that's 15 across the bottom as well. That's 16 here, though. Ooh, we're close. We're close. Ooh, we're getting real close. This is 11. Man, we're getting close here. Okay. Maybe we need the 1 to be here. And then we need the 8 to be here, maybe? And that gives me... okay, so now we have... The top is different now is the problem. 12... No, wait. That's 15. 12, 15. 10, 15. 13, 15. And then over here we have 15. We have 15. And this is the only one that... Wait, no. Oh, but we gotta go diagonal too. Shit, I wasn't thinking about diagonals. Fuck. Okay, so that's 11, 12. Shit. We're close. And the 213 does not work. Oh my god. You 213 garbage. Okay. God damn it. Okay, 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 okay. Can we swap? Shit. The 2 and the 3 is ruining, man. What can I swap here? I'm so close. Everything else is 15. Oh my god, that's frustrating that only the diagonals is wrong. What do I have to switch here to make this right? Probably the whole goddamn thing to make it work. What can I shift? God damn it. I wasn't thinking about the diagonals. Diagonals. Okay, so this one, what'd I say this one? This one's only fucking 6 this way. That's way off. Damn. Damn, this is a conundrum, to say the least. Okay. Okay. I don't even know where to start on this, dude. I don't even know right now, dude. What am I doing? The 9 and the 8 can never go together, otherwise that's too much. And the 9 and the 7 either. The 9 and the 7 and the 9 and the 8 cannot be in the same, like, row ever. They have to be in rows that never touch each other. So it has to be something like this, where they never, ever in the same lines. They can't be vertical or horizontal or diagonal of each other. So that's the only two places they can be, right? All right, so let's operate on that assumption. Because 9 and 6 can never go together either, because that's too high. So it can't be in any of these... Ooh, really? 9 and 6 can't be in the same path either. Well, the 9... Okay, so 9 can't be there. 9's got to be, like, in one of these kind of spots. And then 6 can be with either one of them, because 13 and 14 can be... You just can't be where the 9 is. So you can go here. Let's see. If I do that, you need to put the 1... No, the 2 has to go here. And the 1 has to go here. Okay. And then... This diagonal thing is making me working my brain, man. It's working my brain. All right, so if 11 this way, that means the 4's got to go here. And this is 12, so 3 has to go here. And And then that's 15. So let's hope this works. I do it? This way is not 15. This way. This diagonal is not 15. Son of a bitch. Okay. Backtrack. 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 Okay, the 6 can't go here. So 6 has got to go here then. Basically, I got to just fit them all together in some way. The 8 might be in a different spot too. The 8 and the 7 might have to switch. But let's just go on this assumption right here. Okay, so... or the 8 and the 9 could switch also. But anyway, the point is, let's see where this goes. Okay, so slightly different way to go here. So the 1 has to go in the middle now, which I think it was wasn't before, right? And 7, 6, so this one has to be a 2 right here. And then the 4 has to go down here now, which still doesn't work because 4, 1, 7, okay. I'm putting the 8 up in the corner. Putting the 8 up in the corner. The 7 can't be that integral. That's the problem. Okay, so let's backtrack again. I put the 6 where I had it here. Out of the way. Okay, so 1's got to go here. 2's got to go here. 11, 4's got to go here. 5's got to go here. And I'll just put the 3. Yes! Awesome! There we go, all pins inserted, all lights lit. That's the kind of puzzle I like doing, personally, so I'm sorry if that was boring to watch, but hell yeah, dude. Math. We did it. The power's on now. Hell yeah. Looks like there's electricity going in the monitor on top now. Alright, let's see if we can activate the device on top. Fuck yeah, dude. Let's do some Operation Move Box stuff. Green button, red button, and a lever. I wonder what these do. I think this might help. What? What the hell is this? Where did he find this? What is that? Where'd you find it? I found it when we were messing around with the pinholes. Looks like instructions for this thing. According to what it says here, this thing's a remote control for that. That? Yeah, that. What's he pointing to? That machine over there. Apparently it's called the Pushmaster 5000. Are you serious? Whatever. So, what are we supposed to do with the Pushmaster 5000? You see the coffin over there on top of the crates? Yeah? Don't you want to know what the deal is with it? I do. You want to check it out? Yeah? Alright. How do you think we're going to get there? Well, there's some crates on the right side of the fence that someone piled up like stairs. Maybe if we make a path to the coffin from there. How would we do that? Line up the crates, I guess. Yeah, that sounds about right. I guess this is just another one of Zero's puzzles. Yep. Anyway, let's give it a shot. Oh, looks like the Pushmaster 5000 runs off a battery, so keep it from using up its energy too fast. It's been programmed so that it only starts moving once its path has been completely programmed in. Alright, keep that in mind. Great. Fucking great. Do we have to read this shit? Oh, great. Instructions. Great. In order to prolong, simulate your actions before carrying them out. Push the lever to begin. Okay. You can move in 4 directions. You cannot move diagonally. If the Pushmaster 5000's move count exceeds the battery life, it will be reset. Cannot lift heavy objects. Reset the green. Quit is red. Move it around to start a command. Got it. I think we understand. Let's do it. Monitor, blah, blah, blah. Once I start sending my hand, I just pull the lever. All right, let's give it a try. Sure thing. Just keep in mind that there's a limit on the battery, all right? Battery dies after 50 moves. At least that's what it says in the manual. 50 moves, huh? Also keep in mind that the Pushmaster 5000 can't move the heavy metal crates, okay? Got it. Instructions for operation. When a square adjacent to the Pushmaster 5000 is touched, the Pushmaster 5000 will move to that square. If there's a crate in the way, the Pushmaster will push up to a single crate. Move the crates appropriately and efficiently and fill the yellow areas. This is weird, but okay. We need to get all the yellow boxes in 50 moves or less. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay. Let me just think. Think. Think hard. Think fast. Think smart. So the only option we have to start is to push this one this way. Question is, do we want to push this one that way as well? Actually, think we're okay to move over here. Push this down. And then we can move this here. Now, shit, that won't work. I don't think that will work. Because if I do that, then I don't know what to do with the bottom one. Yeah, reset. Okay, oh my god, this is going to be a fun puzzle. I actually like these kind of puzzles too. I'm liking the puzzles in this room more than any other thing that we've done. This is actually great. I like this. Okay, yeah, so literally our only choice is to push... Oh, no, 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 we... Hold on. We have more rows on the bottom to deal, like, to move around with. Right? I do that. I can go around here, push this one down. Let's see if that works. Move around here. Push this one back. Push this one down. Push this one back. Push this one over. Push this one here. And then go up, 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 up. I don't know if this is going to work in 50 moves. Let's see. We can push this one down. Yeah. I'm gonna go ahead in here and push this one this way. And then I'm gonna push you up. I don't know if I'm gonna do this in 50 or less is the problem. Ah, crap. How am I supposed to... Ah, crap. I had to move one into that... I have to move one here. I mean, sorry, in this, I have to move one right here. Somehow. And the only way to do that is to put one right here. And I fucked that up, I think. Yeah, I definitely did. Yeah, I can't finish it. Next time on Let's Play 999, I'm going to solve this puzzle. We're closing in on an hour, so this is a perfect place to stop. I will have this puzzle... Well, I mean, I'll spend the next episode solving the puzzle. It'll probably take a few minutes. But I think... I mean, I know what I need to do now. So, we'll do it next time. See you guys then. Peace!